burden.
What up, what up? This is Jeff Stones, representing Jeff Stones for Life, and you are in the field with Track Stars. You already know what it is.
Yeah, back in the field with the Track Stars, Ryan Righteous, Sean Tanner, DJ Jeremiah. We got a noteworthy for you, man. We are so behind in these, and I apologize. I know y'all been waiting for us to answer these. All right, so this one is called Help, My Wife is Trapped in a Cult. So this is serious. All right, it says, Hello, Track Stars. I want to say I love your show, and I have rewatched all the topics and noteworthy vids at least twice. Y'all are hilarious and very loving, well-rounded Christians. I wish I could find people like you locally. Back to the reason for this email. My wife and I were raised Jehovah's Witnesses. It seems like no big deal, but for those who don't know, it is a very dangerous cult. They destroy families, kill people, refusal of blood doctrine, and most importantly, rewrote the Bible to keep its members from being saved. I was a Jehovah's Witness until I turned 25 and got saved 3 years ago. When I found Christ, it destroyed my marriage and we actually got divorced. The reason is that when you leave the Jehovah's Witnesses, you are shunned. No member is able to speak to you. Being that all of both our families are Jehovah's Witnesses, we thought the marriage could never work. But after a year of getting closer to God and unbrainwashing ourselves, my wife and I realized the divorce was not biblical, so we remarried. She is an amazing woman, and we just had a daughter 9 weeks ago. But she is still a Jehovah's Witness and wants to raise our daughter in the religion. But I want to raise our whole family as Christians. What do I do? She is willing to listen and converse about how we will raise our daughter, but I feel outnumbered by both sides of our family all being witnesses. Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope.
Yeah. My wife and I, we talked about this one once before. What do you think he's asking us? Is he asking us to give him advice on whether or not he should stay in his marriage if it's not God honoring? Or is he asking us, should he go against the grain and raise his children the way he wants? I was confused about what the question was.
Is the first one an option?
The first one is not an option.
So then not that one.
Well, okay, this is the part. He said he was divorced at one time, right? They divorced because he became a Christian and she didn't want to follow.
Yep.
He went back to the relationship because he figured that God hated divorce. Right?
Yep.
So I really don't know the question that I'm supposed to be answering. The
question is, what is he supposed to do? Period. What would you do?
Man, man. That's difficult. Of course, if he's reading the Bible the way he should be and he's understanding interpretation, then he knows that God looks at him to be the head of that household, and he's pretty much, I think, has to override the ungodly principles in his household for the godly, and I think that he has to make a decision and put his foot down.
What if he just came out and told her, like, we're in a cult, like, you know what I'm saying, like, we're in a cult. What we've been teaching is false doctrine.
I'm sure he's done that.
I mean, the way it sounds like he hasn't.
He said his side of the family, her side of the family, they're all against him because once you get out of being a witness, you're shunned by the witness.
Yeah, so, you get disfellowship.
And he said he's having a hard time because he feels that both sides are against him, both sides of the family. So I think he's already said,
well, I'm saying,
to everybody, this is a cult.
No, but what I'm saying is, like, have that real conversation about it with his wife, like, hey, you know, the situation we're in, I want to raise our daughter Christian, mm-hmm. the Jehovah's Witness. It seems like it's the same thing, but it's not.
I'm going to give you one of those Sean Tanner questions. But, you know, he asks a question and you really don't want to answer it, but he don't want to answer it either. So the question is, would you have gone back to the marriage after the divorce?
He went back. What's the reason he went back?
He went back because he said he felt God hated divorce.
Oh, is that okay. Right?
That's what I read. Go ahead.
Okay. Well, see, it has to be a reason for the divorce. Like, if I got divorced, it'd be a reason.
He said they were arguing about Christianity versus being a witness. And him wanting to.
So did he get the divorce papers? Well, he probably didn't go in depth like that, but I mean, I'm thinking about the scripture that talks about, like, if your person ain't saved and you're sticking with them and there's a possibility that you could bring them to Christ, You know what I'm saying? So yeah. That could be a possibility too, is that he being the man of God and living up to a standard that she's like, I'll submit to that. Let me get a part. Let me be a part of that. So I'll submit to that. And then she could leave the Jehovah's Witness as well. Stop being a Jehovah's Witness.
Do y'all know what Jehovah's Witnesses believe?
I know. Yeah. I mean, I have a friend who's invited me to Bible studies and I've been in the house, but I've been trying to tune out when they talk. So,
I
know the basics.
We need to get back to that. I guess we made people mad, so that's why we stopped doing it.
What?
Like doing those exposés and stuff.
Jehovah's Witness. I remember when I was a kid, my dad was an evangelist. Like he actually went out and talked to people and got people saved. And I remember Jehovah's Witnesses used to come to our house in Florida.
Yeah.
And they came in trying to preach to us.
Yeah.
And he would let them in. And then when they came, they walked out like their whole life is now confusing because my dad put it on them.
Yeah.
So I remember those conversations. I remember what they were trying to say. You know, it's confusion. Honestly, I think a lot of it is confusion over the end times.
Yeah.
A lot of people get confused by revelations and they make big proclamations based off revelations. Mm-hmm. Their leader, what's his name again?
John Smith.
Is it John Smith?
No, that's
Mormons.
Mormons. Oh, okay.
But Charles T. Russell.
But I would say this: they do switch stuff in the Bible to make Jesus not be the Savior, though.
Yeah. Now that's what.
There's big things about the biggest thing is the 144,000.
Yeah.
You know, in
Revelation,
the 12 the tribes, and they believe that's, you know, the only people who are going to get to either be on the earth or
go to heaven.
The rest is going to be on earth. I just think it's a lot of confusion around revelations, and this is the danger. God said, don't add or take away anything from my word, because I think people see things and then they're like, oh, I know what that means. And then they build this whole doctrine based off of it and expect people to just follow it. Mm-hmm. And that's the danger. That's what a cult is. It's something that the gospel that was preached, they've changed something about it because they feel like they got some revelation. And now it's Christian-like.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's the danger of it, is because it's so close, but it changes the most important detail about Christianity is Christ.
Yeah.
So that's the danger of it. Christ has to be, he said, if anybody says that Christ is not both God and man, it's a cult.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was friends with one girl for a very long time in college, man. And she told me, she was like, if you would just drop everything that you think you believe right now, we could get married if you become a witness. And I'm like, nah. But she told me the difference that she has is that she doesn't believe that Jesus is God.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. My thing is, like, when I would go back and forth with her on scripture, you know, she would always say, yeah, but that's not supposed to be in there. And this is, I mean, they have different Bibles too.
Yeah, that's another thing too. They have a totally different, their New World Translation makes Jesus just human. Yeah. Not God.
It's a rewording of John 1. You know, it's famous. It's an awesome writing for John 1. It's like, you know, in the beginning was God. God, you know, God was the Word. The Word was God. And in the beginning, God created. Like, that's amazing imagery and wordplay. Like, you're talking about lyricism. That's great wordplay because it reveals that the Bible you read is considered the Word of God.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Jesus, the person you worship, is the Word of God that you read.
Yeah.
He didn't just say the Word of God, he is it. Yeah. And this is this crazy imagery, and that same Word is the person who made you.
Yeah.
And that's that chapter in the Bible is so groundbreaking because it revealed that Jesus wasn't just something God created.
Yeah.
Jesus existed before everything.
Yeah.
He's the one that created things.
Yeah.
He's the one, when it says that in the beginning God created the world and the voice of God said, you know, let there be this, let there be that, says he's the one that was talking.
Wow.
It was him.
Wow, yeah.
That made you. So it's like that chapter changes everything. And for them to tweak it is really serious.
You know what I learned? A lot of stuff is based off of a lot of cults or other religions are based off work-based stuff. You got to do this, you got to do that. And then I remember one time my brother-in-law was talking about it, and he was saying, why would you, it's like, I'm sure it's more than 144,000 Jehovah's Witness.
Yeah.
So who's going to heaven? You know what I mean? Like, Like, does that make sense
like
to
a,
you? Like,
it's like a
it's almost like millions of Jehovah's Witnesses. So which one of y'all going out of like
the top of the pyramid?
Yeah,
the top
you know what
of the
mean?
Pyramid.
No,
MLM.
No, tell everybody too.
So I mean, those are things that make you think. You know what I'm saying? Think about those questions, like, you know what I mean? Because I know, growing up, man, growing up in New Jersey, they would come to your house every Saturday. You be trying to watch football, college football.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So
the movie Friday messed them up too.
Oh yeah.
No, but I mean, really here's the thing: there's a lot of people who are following this and they believe it wholeheartedly.
Yeah.
And I don't know the dark inner workings of blood, this and that, and getting jumped out and all that kind of stuff. But there's a lot of people who follow this, and same thing with Mormonism and all these other like offshoots of based on Christianity stuff. It's just dangerous, man. Like, don't lose your entire faith because we're poking holes in what you believe now. There's a lot of truth in what you believe, but read the Bible, the one that was written. Like, we're just now getting back to Bible stuff, where the New King James went back further than King James, the actual king, and got the real, and is making sure that everything he translated is accurate, and things have been altered. Make sure you're reading the original. Don't listen. This dude is no better than you. He don't know nothing more than you.
Yeah.
Read the actual Bible and see what it says. Yeah. There's no need for anybody else's interpretation of it. That's just, if somebody says something and it's different than what the actual Bible says, throw it away. It doesn't matter.
In other words, you got to go to a different store to get your Bible.
I think another thing on my heart is when you're talking about your family and like just known, and I've heard celebrities who grew up Jehovah's Witness saying people got disfellowship, like the family don't even talk to them no more.
Yeah.
And just think about that scripture we talk about. Jesus was like, you know, I'm going to put you against your father, your daughters against mother. You know what I'm saying? So understand that being a Christian is going to cost a lot, but at the same time, you're gaining more than...
I think Ryan is like the patriarch type person, and what he says, there's a lot of truth in it. You as the husband, you're required to make sure the path that your family follows is a godly one.
Yeah.
So it's not really a time to be nice and all that kind of stuff. You got to make sure your kids know who Jesus is.
Yeah.
The real Jesus.
Yeah.
So it ain't no, you know, I'm trying to make you happy. This kind of, when it comes to Jesus, ain't no playing around. You got to get that right.
Yep.
So that would be my suggestion. I just pray for your wife. We'll pray for her, because that's serious. I mean, when you've been learning something and you think it's true for a really, really long time, it's hard to break away from that. And that's why I'm always sensitive to it, because it would be hard for me to find out that all this ain't right.
Yeah.
I mean, think about it. Like, we're not being fair. Yeah. If somebody grew up learning something and we're telling them to change everything you think because we're telling you it's something different, how hard would it be for y'all to all of a sudden be Muslims or Baha'i or like, it would be very difficult. But truth is truth. Is it true or is it not true? So just be sensitive to people. You're trying to get them to change their whole life, and you would never be willing to do the same. So that's a hard task, man. You just got to be patient, man. Keep praying for it. God will, you'll start seeing the change coming. All right? You in the field with the Track Stars, Ryan Wright, Sean.